Hey guys, this is Faye from Feisworld Media, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use Google Ads to drive views for your videos. In addition to that, you will also notice a significant revenue number for this video. So I just want to explain that sometimes it's even worth balancing and sending ads to your videos that you suspect will have a high CPM. Now, you could be wrong. Anybody could be, because it's hard to predict exactly what the CPM may be. But I'm going to include in the description below, you're able to predict the 17 high paying CPMs depending on your video topics and niches. So let's get started. By the end of this video, make sure you watch till the end. I will show you step by step exactly how to read Google Ad Analytics, how to set it up for your single video, how to choose your audience, how to set your price. You have the option to use your regular YouTube video to start, but you could also create additional ad video that is more engaging, especially within the first 5 seconds or the first 10 to 15 seconds, so that people want to watch more and maybe even click on learn more or view more to go to the destination of your choice. Let's get started. I'm not recommending that you necessarily need to use this technique for every single video, but if you were pivoting to a new category, or you know, you have a sponsor video, but perhaps into a new category or a new sponsor with content and videos are not getting a ton of traction, then you can really use this to boost the traffic. I'm going to prove it to you. So right here, here's a new category called business banking for self-employed. I started driving traffic there just about a few days ago, and only for $50 altogether over the course, I would say, you know, 7 to 10 days, but you can make it however many days you want, 5 to 7 days or so, depending on the video launch frequency. But as you can see, when I first launched the video, I can tell right away that it was below my average number of views, right? You can see the gray area shows you the potential of videos on my channel and as progress over time. Now, the blue line was reality for it. So what I did as of, let's see, February 25th, I sent just a few dollars, I think $5 a day or so, to this video and immediately goes up. I know the argument is that just by sending paid traffic through doesn't mean that these are high quality traffic. But as a content creator, you know, you don't know everything about your own content, your own channel. If it needs a boost, then it's actually worth kind of exploring whether it's worth it or not. So if we take a look at the watch time, you see there's a really big difference that just kind of jumped. That means people are actually watching the video. In terms of YouTube video ads, it's both a combination of the number of views, but as well as, I think it's mostly around the number of views, because each view may be, you know, 5 seconds or 10 to 15 seconds. So I'm going to show you real quick on what the results look like for this found intro video. And then immediately after that, I'm going to show you how to set up one from scratch, including how to edit your videos slightly differently so that you can gauge the most amount of traction. So if I go to my overview page, again, this is all you're seeing here, and let's limit to the past 7 days, because that's really February 25th. You see, there's nothing before then. So it's giving me data based on the number of impressions. That is pretty impressive. In less than 7 days, in 7 days exactly, there are impressions. People have seen it for 1,300 times, 1,340. And the number of views, the people who actually watched the ad for more than 5 seconds, there were 250 people. That makes the average cost, based on how much money I spend, is 8 cents per view that I pay. That's not a lot of money. And the view rate for people who did end up watching the video, they watched nearly 20%. So I can tell that 20% kind of ends right here, right? And then it kind of flattened out. So one of the reasons I want to explain is I wanted to use this video exactly as it was. It probably wasn't very ideal, because guess what? My regular YouTube video will have some of the, you know, sponsorship information, my intro at the beginning. What you might want to consider, since the first 5 seconds, and especially after that, the first 10 to 15 seconds are critical, you want to edit out any unnecessary information, right? So that's definitely something to keep in mind. I'll show you you in a second how to do that and compare the two videos, one I launched for YouTube versus the one I use for YouTube ads. Now you want to select the placements that are right for your channel. I will go into specific details too, which is you want to find channels that you potentially are watching, you enjoy, that resonate with you. So one thing that came to mind, I am subscribed to a number of personal finance channels. You're not even seeing all of them right now. If I click on all placements, hopefully that will give you a bigger and brighter list. As you can see, you probably recognize some of these folks. But just because I want to place my video there doesn't mean it will necessarily shown there. You'll also notice that Google Ads or YouTube Ads has this intelligent radar to detect how many impressions versus how much you're spending. So essentially it's trying to save you money all the time and trying to give you the most return on your buck without, you know, still showing the views, giving you the views, but also balance how much money you're spending. If you have never done ads before, you know, you really want to give it a shot because you end up learning so much about where your audience is, you know, their gender, their age, as you can see here, the devices that they're using, and, you know, how much of your videos are showing on YouTube videos versus display networks. And you can also disable display networks if you don't want to have your videos played on there. And here, the darker these areas are, the more people that you will see, you'll find who are watching your video. So I'm kind of like a little bit surprised by some of the stuff. Like, for example, I'm based in Massachusetts. It's a tiny state. It's not bad, but turns out the majority of my views actually come from parts in Canada and California and also Texas. So, you know, some of this is based on where I'm placing these ads too, just to keep that in mind. And in terms of age and gender, it's pretty even. But, you know, once you get yourself familiar with Google Ads, you can actually eliminate some of these age groups if you want to. So I don't really see the need to eliminate that just yet. I feel like even young people these days are really keen on learning about personal finance. I personally know a number of people in their 20s who are starting up their businesses for the first time. I also just kind of hover over to see my CPV, which is the average cost I'm spending on these cohorts. It's not like one is significantly more expensive than the other. At that point, I can make a decision. It's a little tricky to navigate in Google Ads. By the way, if this is your first time, set it up simply at ads.google.com. And, you know, it's completely free to sign up. And also, when you first sign up, depending on when you're watching this video, you might even later on get a credit. You know, Google sends this all the time. Hey, here's $100 for free or $200 as soon as you spend your first $100, $150. So it's not free right away. So what you want to do is right here, you can click on video campaigns at the top. And by the way, if you don't see this options, these options, that's because you do not have what's called advanced setting. So that's something that basically what you want to do is be able to enable that. The good news is once you have your ad account, you can actually call Google Ads pretty easily and you will see an option when you sign up for you to engage with these what's called advanced settings. So if you click on your equivalent of tools and settings right now, it's defaulted to basic, and make sure you select advanced. When you do that, you see all of these options, which are all campaigns, display campaigns, video and smart campaigns. So we're talking about video campaigns. Click on new campaigns. From here, do create a campaign without goals or guidance. From here, what you want to do, just straight up video ads. From here, custom video campaign. You don't want to actually even consider the other ones. I won't get into details, but non-skippable. Not only these ads are more expensive, but also you have up to 15 seconds, which for what we're describing doesn't really work. So click on continue once you have all the default options selected. Your campaign name, you can, you know, just create a name that you recognize. I know the first time when you do this, you feel like, I'm just running one ad. I don't even care. But that's okay because you can change these names later on. Enjoy keeping the date there as well. So campaign total, usually I use the day rate. So you can do daily, not more than $5, $10, that's fine. But I'm actually going to use $50 and so I don't have to think about it. So if I start running this right now, I think about on average $5 a day, that gives me about 10 days. So let me roughly select 1 to 10 like that. So you see, right now it says $50 campaign, $5 daily budget that runs out for after 10 days. Now, if you click on this, so I would say right now, I want to just keep it. Remember, we talked about display network earlier, so you can just keep it in YouTube videos like that. I do think that's a pretty good idea. And because I'm talking about taxes, deductions for the US, I'm going to just select US and English here, and everything else can fall exactly as it's designed. Video ad group name, this one, you know, I can just say that this is the edited YouTube ad version, because this is not my original version of the video. Demographic, audiences, you can specify that, but you actually don't have to do all that much, because what you're going to see in a second is how we place these videos, which is I'm going to select YouTube channels focused on personal finance. So here you can search for word, phrase, URL. So you can even search, you can search for a specific YouTube video, or you can search for like your favorite YouTuber name. Here I'm going to say personal finance. So look, finance channels. So here I immediately recognize some of these folks, and you may be wondering, hey, you know, what, you know, how big should these YouTubers be? And I would say you want a variety. You don't want all of them to be a million, 2 million subscribers, because essentially it may be more expensive to pay for these channels. Like, I'm personally a big fan of Andre, and I know he has a really big channel. Actually, he grew a lot, like in the past couple of years too. And, you know, just kind of select a variety and don't get too hung up on making this list perfect. I also like this girl a lot, Investing with Rose. And as you're selecting this, guess what? On the campaign estimate, so you're seeing right here. So I don't have to go crazy, because the impression so far is already 3.5 million, right? So you got plenty going on. Now, the maximum CPV bid is how much you're willing to spend on a video maximum. And so usually, as you can see with my previous example, was 8 cents. Now it could go up to 10, 15 cents. But here, the reason why we want to bid just a little bit higher is because you don't want the videos to be automatically rejected by YouTube. And you can also give it, you know, kind of the flexibility adjustment it just showed you. If I say 10% of top content bid, and it's gonna automatically adjust my upper maximum limit from 20 cents to 22 cents. Here is the fun part, which is after I edit my video, I still have to upload it, guys. I'm not gonna just, you know, magically upload that video to Google Ads. You have to upload your video. The good news is all you have to do is upload your video just like this. And make sure you grab this YouTube new version that you just edited. The reason why I want to demonstrate is it doesn't really matter how, you know, organized this video name needs to be. It just, you know, I can just call it 10 common deductions for self-employed. You don't have to go through all the descriptions, tags, thumbnails like you would with your regular YouTube videos, because this is just an ad, right? People are gonna, you're gonna bounce them off to your actual video, which I'll show you in a second. So this is not gonna take up a lot of time. Just make sure, you know, not for kids. Okay, next. And then monetization, it is off. You know, this doesn't even apply. And you see how fast that is. And just keep going, and that's it. And you're gonna click save. You see there's still 40 seconds left or so as this is being uploaded, and just like that. So it's being uploaded. While you do that, you can still grab the shareable link, but it's not gonna recognize the video until like a minute later. So while it's doing that, boom, it's right there. And this is the last step you need to remember. Click on skippable in-stream ad. So a few things to mention. You can direct people to go to a final URL. Like we talked about earlier, it can be just your regular video. What I mean by that is the YouTube video you uploaded that is not for the ad. So for me, it's this one right here. So let me go ahead and just copy the link, paste it in. And then for the display URL, you can use this, and you can use something different. You can give it a call to action, such as, you know, learn more, as you can see there. And, or you can say, keep watching. But you'll notice that depending on what you put down there, for a couple of things, there are character limits. And so it's really quite limited. So I'm gonna just say, learn more. I believe it's kind of, you know, 10 words perfect. And the headline here is, right now it says Feisworld Media. Sometimes I just keep it the same. But you can also obviously change it. I'll show you real quick. You know, I'll learn more or keep it as Feisworld Media. Funny enough, Feisworld Media is exactly 15 characters, which was not really designed by me. But auto-generate using the companion banner, computer only, so there's that. And you can change your ad name if you want, but to keep it simple, I'm going to click on Create Campaign. And look at that, you are done. And you can actually quickly review everything you just set up, maximum CPV and all that. And there's, you can also kind of collapse and expand and collapse. This button right here kind of gives you everything you need to know, placement. So let me click on continue to campaign. Now, as you can see, to the left-hand side, I have two videos, which is found intro, and then the second video I did for found was found taxes and deductions. Now you can see where all the names appear to be, and this is why, you know, I mentioned earlier why you want these names to be relatively comprehensive, but you can change it later if you want to. So as much, you know, you're going to learn a ton from this process, by the way. Now, quickly on how you're interpreting the data. So I'm going to flip back to the original stats. This is the other video I've been running. So I'm going to go to overview. I would say that it's too early for you to make a decision on whether this ad is working or not after just 1 or 2 days. In fact, you actually have to be quite patient for the first day or two, because Google may or may not, you know, approve your video ad right away. Sometimes it could take up to days, especially if you just opened up a video ad account. So be patient. And beyond that, what you want to do is just monitor it. You can make adjustments, but you don't have to do it every day, usually about once a week or so. These are shorter campaigns that I'm running. But if you're going to run these ads for a longer period of time, if the ones that you find are generating the type of results you like, then checking in once a week is sufficient. Let me know in the comments below what you have learned, what you enjoyed about the video, and tell me about what you learned, because maybe there's something I can learn from you too. Thanks so much for being part of Feisworld Media. I cannot wait to see you in a future video. And the best way to keep in touch is that you hit the subscribe button and then the bell button. So I'll be right back with you for another video within a week.